Can you tell us a little bit about the successes over the last few years, and possibly, you know, maybe a challenge that needs to be addressed?
I think all the studies we have done, they are doing quite well. I mean, even when we had Syrian refugees privately sponsored, we did actually a survey after 6 months, always 60% were working. The reason is these are people that they have some basically social capital when they come in, because there are people that are waiting for them. There are churches, there are community, there are mosques, that they are really part of this whole transition to the Canadian society. And also they are typically small families. There are two, husband and wife, maybe one child, two child. So I think their primary profile, the human capital they bring to Canada, plus the social capital that they gain very quickly, that really makes it very successful. However, I mean, we always caution ourselves that not compare the refugees sponsored by Government of Canada with this cohort, because again, that cohort is a whole different profile they have, because they basically are higher need. Maybe most of them are very traumatized, so they have to really, we have to distinguish between that. But we know, because again, as an agency that I work for, we had over 6,000 people in the past 35 years that they came through that process, and they are doing extremely well.
And well, moving forward, I suppose with the continuing, unfortunate continuing conflict in Syria, but also in, you know, many countries around the world, will the private sponsorship scheme ever evolve or change to broaden the type of individuals that you wish to?
I think it has become much better because our relationship with the federal government is much better. Because again, as I mentioned, we have the sponsor agreement, a national council, that they get together, they look at the numbers, they look at what they need to do. And in Canada, not all the places, but most places, there's a good relationship between sponsoring human holders and the community organization that serve everybody. So that connection also help. Depending really where they have the strongest connection, then they are more successful. So again, Canada obviously, the government of Canada, not all of them, were very, very pro-refugee, and they all really wanted the refugee to come. Because again, I showed in my presentation, Canada is a country that is still settling refugees in their DNA. So they like it, they enjoy doing that. Mm-hmm. And they have seen a result. So because of that, obviously, government is mobilizing the community to do that. And again, we have to remember, the ideas of these people coming here, one thing that in, I think, most extent has been disappearing, our policymaker, our community, us as a SWO, we don't really look at them as them and us. We know they're us. We have to really make sure that they do well. And again, I will look at some of the work that was not done in Europe, and now you guys are basically trying to make it happen. But in Canada, it always was very refugee friendly. A refugee has to work hard. We have to understand the process. Once they are recognized as a process, and then obviously there's a whole mobilization of community, you know, health, education, employment, all these people. And actually, I will tell you this, we have a concept, I could send you actually the information. We work on the concept of wraparound. So we wrap around the refugees. We look at their host volunteers, we connect them with the family. We have case managing for most of them. We are getting better than that, at that particular thing. We have employment, we have program for their children. So we know if we don't pay attention, then there's a price to pay for everybody. So we're trying to really prevent. And then you look at the refugees in Canada. I mean, look at our Governor General, Adrienne Clarkson. She was a refugee. After her, the lady from, I don't remember her name, but she was a refugee. And we have highly rated politician in our community, the mayor of the city of Calgary, that is recognized as the best mayor of the world. He is a Ismaili Muslim child that came with his family 1970 something. So you can see those things. And you go to school, they're doing a lot of good work. So it wasn't there, but is now here.